Oh man, a new macOS is here. But just how different is it? Is it worth upgrading? Let's find out. This is DIY in 5. Hello everyone, welcome to DIY in 5. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and today we are going to go over the basics of Apple's latest operating system, macOS Big Sur. New features and updates, and how to get your fingers typing at the newly WWDC announced OS. This is the first major OS version update in 15 years from Apple, jumping from OS 10 point whatever to 11 point whatever, officially. If you find yourself coming away from today's episode with some new information, please give the video a like, the channel a sub, and the notification bell a ding so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. First, let's talk new features. Big Sur brings with it a lot more customization than Apple users have seen in the past. The control center seen on iOS and iPadOS is now on desktop and customizable for one-click access to common tasks like connectivity, display settings, and more. The notification center can now be grouped by app. Huzzah! And widgets have been redesigned and are resizable, allowing the user to customize the information displayed for easier management. There's also a new customizable Safari start page, allowing the user to set a background image, frequently visited sites, Siri suggestions, reading list, iCloud tabs, and more. One of the new features that can be included on this page is Privacy Report, which uses intelligent tracking prevention to give users a rundown on how many trackers have been blocked and lets you check trackers on a site-by-site basis by clicking on the shield icon next to the URL bar. Also new, thanks to Big Sur, is Safari including built-in translation functionality without the use of an extension, and new redesigned tabs with a hover gesture to show quick page previews. These updates, along with some major aesthetic and efficiency overhauls, should make desktop browsing more user-friendly and productive. Okay, let's talk maps. In addition to being redesigned to better make use of larger, higher resolution screens, maps can now plan out routes that incorporate electric vehicle charging stations, and directions now will take elevation, busy roads, and stairs into account. Indoor maps for malls and airports are now a thing, plus you can look around in maps to explore a detailed street-level view of an area before you go. You'll also notice Guides, which offers a curated destination of nearby sites of interest, and you may already be familiar with from iPadOS, is now available through Big Sur. For the more creative macOS users, you'll be happy to know that the native Photos app has expanded functionality and customization as well. The intensity of photo filters and portrait lighting effects can now be adjusted, and all photo editing tools are now available when editing videos. Speaking of photo editing tools, there's also a handy improved retouching tool that uses machine learning to remove unwanted elements from images. Lastly, for anyone who loves the Messages app on iOS, you'll be happy to know that the Big Sur version of Messages includes many of the same features, like pinned conversations, which sync across all your iOS/iPadOS 14 Apple devices, inline replies and at mentions, supporting Memojis as well, if that's your thing. There's a more robust message search feature as well, so that you have no problem finding that one hilarious meme your best bud sent you that one time. So who gets to try out this new major macOS update, and when can you get your hands on it? Apple has said they plan to release a public beta in July and then officially release in the fall as a free update for all compatible Macs, which they've listed as most 2013 and later devices. You can access the public beta for macOS Big Sur and other new Apple operating systems by going to beta.apple.com. So what are you most looking forward to from this latest version of macOS? Is there anything that you were hoping for that didn't come to fruition? Let us know in the comments. And thank you so very much for watching. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and this is DIY in 5. See you soon.